Dear friends of the Tom Photo channel and all new viewers, GIMP is a powerful free cross-platform image manipulation tool. It competes with Adobe Photoshop and it is my preferred method for JPEG work. Today I'd like to show you how to automate GIMP so that you could batch process your images instead of doing it all manually one image at a time. I'll be referring to this video in my other video, so I need to introduce this topic to you now. Freshly installed GIMP is not capable of batch processing. You need to install a plugin for that. Luckily, this is an easy procedure. You need to install Batch Image Manipulation plugin for GIMP, which is called BIMP. BIMP can be downloaded using this link, and this link also provides instructions for installing BIMP for Windows, Mac, or Linux. You will find a clickable link in the text box below. Although installation procedure is different for different systems, the way you use BIMP is the same for all systems. First, go to File and Batch Image Manipulation to open the Batch Processing dialog. Here you need to choose what you'd like to do to your images, select the images themselves, and specify the output directory. So first click on the plus sign to choose what you'd like to do. For example, select Resize to set up a resize filter. This will make the image smaller the way you specify. You're not limited to one filter. Select as many as you need. The menu option Other GIMP Procedure will offer you a long list of all kinds of functions and plugins you can apply. You can also search for them in the small search window. When you install more plugins, this list gets longer. As an example, let's add Image Rotate 180 degrees to the list of manipulations. Now, when we execute these functions, we are doing two things: making the image smaller and rotating it 180 degrees. Now that this is done, we have to select the images that will enter this simple pipeline of manipulations. Select Add Images and add images one by one or an entire folder at once. What's left to do is select an output directory and click Apply. As simple as that. When this is all done, we see that our photos have become smaller and are upside down, just as we desired. Thank you for watching this brief introduction to batch processing in GIMP. You'll see me refer to this video in my future videos. If you like this video, I invite you to consider subscribing to my channel or leaving a like under the video. Have a great day. Goodbye.